Table 8-5, the eye.
So we talked about the optic nerve already coming off medially, and I showed you two different places we could see the optic nerve. Our conjunctiva, this is kind of a tricky thing for me to show you in lab, but some people think that this kind of yellow area is trying to simplify the conjunctiva. Where the conjunctiva rests, it doesn't cover the cornea, but it'll cover the sclera till about halfway back. And then it starts to fold on top of itself and go inside the palpebrae. Hence, conjunctivitis is pink eye. So that layer that covers that and in there can get inflamed and cause some itching and problems, and it looks pretty gross. It can also make goopy kind of things. So if it were to be pinned in lab, some people are saying it's this yellow thing. But really it covers about halfway back on the sclera and inside the palpebrae. So the layers of the eye wall, we have the fibrous tunic, which is the most outer layer, which includes the sclera, which is this beautiful white part, and then the cornea, which is the bubble kind of on top of the eye right there. So if we're looking, this is another model I really like, but if you're kind of looking at a side angle there, you can see that cornea or bubble. And then all this white stuff is the sclera. The vascular tunic, or the middle layer, has a lot of our vasculature in it, hence vascular tunic. But we have the choroid layer, which is that blue layer, and you can see all the vessels on top of it. This eye, if I take it out, it's all that kind of bluish purple color. All of that is our choroid. Now our ciliary body with our ciliary muscle. The only place I can show you is on a view kind of like this. So if you see here this protrusion sticking out, we'll see if Suzette can get a good angle here. But here we have this body which kind of sticks out, which is an extension of that choroid. And inside that we have ciliary muscles. And these ciliary muscles are what help contract and retract this lens right here, which we'll talk about in a minute. But that pink area, that is our ciliary body with the ciliary muscles. Now, our iris is the colored part of the eye. That's what changes and is different from person to person. So this portion, which is all part of the vascular tunic, so you can kind of see it all runs with that layer, is right here. That's our iris. And our pupil is just simply a hole. So nothing exciting, it's nothing. The pupil is nothing. Kind of weird that everyone thinks the pupil is a black substance, but really it's black because you're staring into the back of the eye, which is dark, there's no light there. So what you're seeing that's black is actually just a hole into dark abyss of things that we'll learn their names. Now the neural tunic is the most inner layer inside. And this pink orangey color is the retina. And then you have the optic disc. The optic disc is this white part. This is where the optic nerve enters into the eye. And so this is our optic disc, which you guys know is your blind spot. There's no rods or cones rested on this spot, but your brain fills in the information that that spot isn't actually visually seeing in the eye. Now you can kind of see how there's a darker orange color and then a yellow circle. That yellow tiny circle is what's called the fovea centralis. And then that darker kind of donut around it is called the macula lutea. And that is where a heavy concentration of cones are, which is the most focused point of the eye. When you concentrate on things, you have the best vision. But so yellow is our fovea centralis, and then the orange is the macula lutea. The ora serrata is on the other part, on the inside here, which is this kind of dark layer right there, that ring around. That's the ora serrata. And on a real eye, it's kind of a pearlescent black. It's like kind of like abalone, shimmery, shiny, like that color. So that's our ora serrata. And a different view here, your ciliary body is, and muscle is in this kind of lip right here. If you kind of see how that has a little jump or lip, that, if I could grab it, that area is where that ciliary body and muscle is located in. So just a different angle, different view.